الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون حمدا ومصليا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. This discussion about the introduction to the Holy Quran according to the Holy Quran. The Holy Quran has said about the Holy Quran itself, and I try to describe about the Holy Quran and introduce to the Holy Quran according to the description of the Holy Quran. This Quran has been revealed to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam through the Jibreel alaihi salatu wasallam, and it is the word of the Almighty Allah. It is the statement and the speech of the Almighty Allah. There is no doubt in this Holy Kitab. Al-Qur'an huwa al-kitab al-munazzal 'ala ar-rasul al-maktub fi al-masahif al-manqul 'anhu naqlan mutawatiran bila shubhatin. This Quran is the kitab that has been revealed on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and written in Masahif, and that has been narrated from the Almighty Allah through the Jibreel alaihi salatu wasallam and from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the mankind of the whole age. And there is no doubt in the narration of this Holy Kitab. The Quran in undoubtedly is the word of the Almighty Allah, because Allah has said in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, verses number 2, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. There is no doubt in this kitab. In other verse of the Holy Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah has said, وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِصُورَةٍ مِّنْ مِثْلِهِ وَدُعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. O people, especially with the unbelievers who doubt in the concept of the Holy Quran, if you enable to produce as like a Holy Quran, to produce a single surah as like a Holy Quran, فَأْتُوا بِصُورَةٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ. In other verse Allah has said, فَأْتُوا بِآيَةٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ. If you are unable to produce a single surah, then you produce a single ayah. In other words, Allah has said and Allah declared a challenge to the unbeliever people, if you are unable to produce a single ayah, فَلْيَأْتُوا بِحَدِيثٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ, then you produce a single word as like Holy Quran. This is the challenge of the Almighty Allah to the unbelievers of the whole world of holy for all age, but they don't able to take this challenge. And in every age, all the scholar and educated people try to produce as like the Holy Quran, but they failed, and they undoubtedly failed. And they have said that laysa hadha kalamul bashar, this Holy Quran is not the speech of the mankind. This is not the statement of the mankind. It is only the statement and speech of the Almighty Allah that has been revealed on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam through Jibreel alaihi salatu wasallam. The Holy Quran has says about the truthness of the Holy Quran itself. Ayat Surah Yunus, ayat number 37. وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ أَن يُفْتَرَى مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَلَكِن تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَتَفْصِيلَ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ مِن رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. This Quran is not produced by other than Allah. وَلَكِن تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. But it is a complete explanation of the previous kitab. وَتَفْصِيلَ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ مِن رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And a complete explanation of the kitab and symbol of verses, this is from the Almighty Allah. Quran is a book of truth. The Holy Quran says about that Surah Zumar, ayat number 41. Inna anzalna alayka al-kitaba lin-nasi bil-haqq faman ihtada falinafsi wa man dhalla fa innama yadhillu alayha wa ma anta alayhim biwakeel. Surely and of coursely, we reveal this kitab on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in properly and with true. فَمَنِ اِهْتَدَى فَلِنَفْسِي وَمَنْ ضَلَّ فَإِنَّمَا يَضِلُّ عَلَيْهَا. So, who received this truthness of the Holy Quran, he received this for his own benefit. And who get astray and to the wrong path from the Holy Quran, he is a real loser. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِوَكِيلِ. And Allah addressed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are not wakil to them. In other verse, Surah Ar-Ra'd, verses number 1, Allah has said, تِلْكَ آيَاتُ الْكِتَابِ وَالَّذِي أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ الْحَقِّ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. This is the verses of the Holy Quran. This is the ayats of the Holy Quran that has been revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. But most of the people don't understand the reality of the Holy Quran. Quran is a book that discussed about the mankind and guidance of to the mankind. Surah Al-Anbiya, ayat number 10. Allah has said about it, لَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ كِتَابًا فِيهِ ذِكْرُكُمْ أَفَلَا تَعَقِلُونَ. Of course, we have revealed the Holy Quran to you, O Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam. There is a reminder, an advice in the Holy Quran, أَفَلَا تَعَقِلُونَ. O people, do you not understand the reality and the meaning and concept of the Holy Quran? Surah Al-Isra has described about this, وَلَقَدْ صَرَّفْنَا فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لِيَذَّكَّرُوا فَأَبَىٰ أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ إِلَّا كُفُورًا. This Quran I have revealed and described all these things very details, so that the human and mankind can be able to understand the concept and topics of the Holy Quran, and they disciplined lead a disciplined and comfortable life according to the command and advice of the Holy Quran, and get a final destination, that is the heaven, and free from the hellfire on the day of judgment and on the day of resurrection. وَالَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِكُمْ لَرَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. He is the Lord who revealed the Quran to you, O Muhammad, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that who bring the people out from the darkness to the light. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِكُمْ لَرَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. And Allah the Almighty is very merciful to the mankind and very gracious to the mankind. Belief in Quran is a part of being righteous and pious. The Holy Quran has said about the لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَن تُوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ قِبَلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين وآتى المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل. This verse described a standard criteria of to be a pious and righteous people. According to the description of this verse, the standard criteria is of being righteous and pious people is the ikhlas, that is the purity of niyat. Quran was revealed to be recited as it is itself. The Holy Quran has said about it. Surah Al-Baqarah, verses number 121. الَّذِينَ أَتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. The people whom we have revealed and granted the Holy Kitab, يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ, they recite this Holy Kitab perfectly and properly by performing amal according to this command of this Kitab. وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. And the people who denies this command of this Holy Kitab, they are really the loser. Quran is Allah's word that brought by the honorable angel Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam to the mankind to lead a comfortable and a disciplined life. وَإِنَّكَ لَتُلَقَّ الْقُرْآنَ مِنْ لَدُنْ حَكِيمٍ عَلِيمٍ. This is the Kitab that is revealed from the Almighty Allah, who is all knowing and all wisdom. Quran is Allah's word that was revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Surah Al-Furqan, verses number 32. Allah has said, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ عَلَيْهِ الْقُرْآنُ جُمْلَةً وَاحِدًا كَذَلِكَ لِنُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ وَرَتَّلْنَاهُ تَرْتِيلًا. This is the answer of a question that was asked by the unbeliever people to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. They asked to the people, O Muhammad, why the whole Quran has not been revealed all at a time? Allah has described and replied this answer. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ عَلَيْهِ الْقُرْآنُ جُمْلَةً وَاحِدًا كَذَلِكَ لِنُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ وَرَدَّ اللَّهُ تَرْتِيلًا. But the Holy Quran has revealed on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during about 23 years according to demand and necessity of the mankind. Because Allah knew very well that the mankind don't able to abide by the commands and the advice of the Holy Quran at time and within a short time, so that he revealed the Holy Quran about 23 years during a long time. Nothing like Quran can be produced. Surah Al-Isra has described, قُلْ لَئِنْ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. Quran guides to the way of peace. يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَهُ سُبُلَ السَّلَامِ وَيُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَيَهْدِيهِمْ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Allah guides the people to the right path who seeks the satisfaction of Allah. مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَهُ سُبُلَ السَّلَامِ وَيُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ بِإِذْنِهِ. And to bring the people out of their darkness to the light, it is by the command of Allah. وَيَهْدِيهِمْ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. And he guides the people to the righteous and the right path. Quran is a divine revelation, divine sending, that should be treated as such. The Quran has said about that Surah Al-Hashr, لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَىٰ جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ وَتِلْكَ الْأَمْثَالُ نَضْرِبُهَا لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Allah has said, if I sent this kitab on the mountain or hill, you mostly and of coursely see the mountain trembling in fear of Allah. وَتِلْكَ الْأَمْثَالُ نَضْرِبُهَا لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. And this example we described in the Holy Quran so that the main people, the people can take the advice from this description of Almighty Allah. The Holy Quran has said about in the other verse, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملنها وأشفقن منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. I have presented this amanat, that is the responsibility of bearing the Holy Quran to the mountain, to the heavens, to the earth. But all of them denied to carry and hold this, the responsibility of the Holy Quran. Only the human takes this responsibility, and this great human is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, selected by the Almighty Allah. And the thousands of Hafiz Quran and a lot of Hafiz Quran in the present world carry and holds the whole Quran in their chest and breast. And Allah has said, "Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafizun." I have revealed this, the Holy Quran, and I guard it from all kind of, every kind of corruption. So, Hafiz Quran are the holder and carrier of the Holy Quran. Allah has said, "Iqra, wartaqi, warattil, warat, kama kunta turattil fi dunya, fa inna manzilaka 'inda akhir ayatin taqra'uha." On the day of judgment and resurrection, Allah give to the Hafiz Quran a chance to be right to the unbelievable, wonderful building. And he said, "Iqra, read, wartaqi, and write, warattil kama kunta turattilu fi dunya." Write a verse, recite a verse, and write every step of this building that has been gifted by the Almighty Allah to the Hafiz Quran. Especially to the Hafiz Quran. كَمَا كُنْتَ تُرَتِّلُ فِي الدُّنْيَا. How you read the Holy Quran in your worldly life. فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَكَ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَوْهَا. Your final destination is that. How much you can be able to recite at the final destination. Quran provides us a complete code of life. وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الذِّكْرَ وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ. Surah An-Nahl has described about that. Surah An-Nahl has described about that. وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الذِّكْرَ كِتَابٍ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. I have revealed the kitab, that is the explanation of all things. وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ, that is the guidance and mercy and a good tidings and glad tidings to the Muslim, for the Muslims. Surah Yunus has described, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. O people, there is come to you a advice from your Lord, washifa, and this Quran is a card of all kinds of mental disease that are hidden in your hearts and chest. Warahmatun wa bushra lil muslimin, and it is mercy and a good tidings for the Muslim. Ununazzilu min al-Quran ma huwa shifaa'u wa rahmatun lil mu'minin, and this Quran is also a curing of all mental disease. It purifies the mental disease, every kind of mental disease, and is purifies our mind, our thinking. It is. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah has said, "We have created, we have revealed the Holy Quran, and this, the verses of the Holy Quran are the cure of all kinds of mental disease." وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ, and good tidings for the Muslim. Quran message has no contradiction. Allah has said, مَا نَنْسَخْ مِنْ آيَةٍ أَوْ نُنْسِهَا نَأْتْ بِخَيْرٍ مِّنْهَا أَوْ مِثْلِهَا أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Allah has said, when we remove any verse of the Holy Quran, or we replace any verse of the Holy Quran by other verse, I grant and put in the Holy Quran the better verse than the previous verse. And this can be happened naskhul Quran bil Quran, naskhul bil Quran bil Hadith, and naskhul Hadith bil Quran, and naskhul Hadith bil Hadith. These four kinds of nask can be worked in nask, and this nask in present time is stopped because the Holy Quran has said, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. And this day Allah has completed the final boundary of the Holy Quran. So there is no opportunity or chance to addition or subtraction from the verses of the Holy Quran. And it is a very challenge and an important challenge to the dweller of the whole world and to the followers of the whole religion, because Quran has no chance to addition or subtraction in this verse. Alhamdulillah alladhi anzala ala abdihi alkitab walam yaj'al lahu iwaja. All praise belongs to the Almighty Allah. This is the verse of the Surah Al-Kahf. They describe that all praise belongs to Almighty Allah. Alladhi anzala alkitab walam yaj'al lahu iwaja. Who has sent down the kitab to the selected prophet alayhi salatu wassalam, and he don't make any kind of contradiction in this Holy Quran. The Holy Quran has described about the almost 5 or 6 names in the Holy Quran. The names is described by the Holy Quran. Al-Kitab, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. The second name is Al-Zikr. Inna nahnu nazzalna al-Zikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. The third name is Al-Furqan. Tabarak alladhi nazzal al-Furqan ala abdihi liyakuna lil'alameen nadhira. The fourth name is Al-Nur. Qad jaa'atkum maw'izatum min rabbikum wa shifa'un lima fi s-sudur. Qad jaa'akum min Allahi nuru wa kitabun mubin. This is the verses that describe the name of the Holy Quran. So, we should recite the Holy Quran and understand and try to understand the meaning of the Holy Quran so that we can lead a good life according to the ideal example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because Hazrat Aisha said, "Kana khuluquhu al-Quran." The character of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was as like the character. Is like the description of Holy Quran. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a Alif Quran. If you can try to understand the Holy Quran and lead a life according to the Holy Quran, commands of Holy Quran, and describe that has been described by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in many hadith. So we can be prospered in life in here and hereafter. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless us by a Islamic life. Waffaqana Allahu wa iyyakum. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.